Faça a tua nova de bom que faz. 보이스가 가슴 도셔 노래 가능한 느낌이 되는지 지리치어 뭐가 떠오르네 아는다 떠오르네 날뜨리겠네 믿으니 뭐가 되거로 너기 아 가려는 거 내가 가려는 거 같아 그치 그치 이제 바람이 예수로 모시네 할렐루야 아멘 നിങ്ങൾ കണ്ടിൽ നിങ്ങൾ അടുത്തിരിക്കുന്നത് എത്ര സുന്ദരൻ എത്ര സുന്ദരിയാണ് നിങ്ങൾ അടുത്തിരിക്കുന്നത് ആണോ ആണെങ്കിൽ ഒരു നല്ലൊരു ഒന്ന് പറ്റിട്ടെന്ന് പറഞ്ഞേ സുന്ദരനാണെന്ന് പറയാം ഈ രാത്രി നാ കർത്താവിൽ സന്തോഷിക്കാനുള്ളവരാണ് നമ്മളെ ജീവൻ നൽകി നമ്മളെ നിർത്തി നമ്മളെ കർത്താവായതുകൊണ്ട് എത്ര പേരുടെ സന്തോഷം ഉണ്ടതിനകത്ത് നമ്മൾ ആദ്യം പാടിയത് അങ്ങനെയായിരുന്നു ഇന്നലെ മുമ്പിൽ പാർത്തിരുന്ന എത്ര പേർ ഈ ലോകപ്പെട്ടു പോയി ഞാൻ നമുക്ക് ഒരു ദിനം കൂടി നൽകി ആ കർത്താവിനെ നാം പാടി സ്തുതിക്കും തുടർന്ന് ഞാൻ പാടാൻ പോകുന്നത് നിങ്ങൾക്ക് എല്ലാവർക്കും അറിയാവുന്നൊരു പാട്ടാണ് സൃഷ്ടാവാം ദൈവമേ അന്വേഷുവേ നിത്യനാം ദൈവമേ അന്വേഷുവേ ഉന്നതനാം നായകനെ വന്ദ്യതനാം നായകനെ സൗഖ്യത്തിന് നായകനെ കർത്താതി കർത്താവ് വരുന്നു ഞാൻ നിത്യ സമിതിയിൽ ഹല്ലേലൂയ പ്രൈസ് ഗോഡ് ഞാൻ ഈ പാട്ട് പാടുന്നതിന് മുമ്പ് അതിൻ്റെ ഒരു അനുഭവം ഞാൻ എന്തായാലും പറയും കാരണം ഇതെഴുതിയത് എൻ്റെ സുഹൃത്താണ് തൻ്റെ പേര് ജോമോൻ എന്നാണ് ഞാൻ മുമ്പേ പറഞ്ഞത് എന്തിനാണെന്ന് അറിയാമോ തൊട്ടടുത്തിരിക്കുന്ന സുന്ദരനാണോ സുന്ദരിയാണോ എന്ന് ചോദിച്ചതിൻ്റെ കാര്യം ഞാൻ എപ്പോഴും പറയാറുണ്ട് കാരണം ഈ പാട്ട് എഴുതിയ എൻ്റെ സുഹൃത്ത് ഭയങ്കര ആഴമായിട്ട് ദൈവത്തിൻ്റെ സൃഷ്ടാവിനെ വർണ്ണിച്ചുകൊണ്ട് എഴുതിയ പാട്ടാണ് അപ്പം ഇത് പാടാൻ വേണ്ടിയിട്ട് താൻ എന്നെ വിളിച്ചു ആറ്റം കുറവുള്ളൂ എനിക്ക് ബാക്കി എല്ലാം കറക്റ്റായിരുന്നു അപ്പൊ ഞാൻ പാടാൻ വേണ്ടി ചോദിച്ചു പാടിക്കൊണ്ടിരുന്നപ്പോ എന്റെ കണ്ണ് പറയാൻ തുടങ്ങി എനിക്ക് പാടി തീർക്കാൻ പറ്റുന്നില്ല കാരണം ആ പാട്ട് എഴുതിയ സുഹൃത്ത് താൻ ജനിച്ചപ്പോൾ തന്നെ രണ്ട് ഓപ്പറേഷൻ താൻ വിധേയനായി എന്തുകൊണ്ടെന്ന് നമുക്കുള്ളത് പോലൊരു മുഖം തനിക്കുണ്ടായിരുന്നില്ല ഏകദേശം ഫേസിന് ഇത്രയും ഭാഗം തന്നെ ഓപ്പൺ ആയിരുന്നു തന്നെ ഇങ്ങനെ നോക്കിക്കഴിഞ്ഞ ഒരു അത്ഭുത ചീനിയെ പോലെയായിരുന്നു എല്ലാവരും കണ്ടത് രണ്ട് ഓപ്പറേഷൻ ജനിച്ച ഉടനെ ചെയ്തു പക്ഷെ രണ്ടും പരാജയപ്പെട്ടുപോയി തന്നെ വീട്ടിൽ കൊണ്ടുവന്നപ്പോ ഒരു പാസ്പോർട്ട് പോലെയായിരുന്നു എല്ലാവരും പറഞ്ഞുകൊണ്ട് ഫിലിപ്പ് ഹോസ്പിറ്റലിൽ ഒരു അത്ഭുത ജീവിയുണ്ട് ഹോസ്പിറ്റലിൽ വരുന്ന എന്തെങ്കിലുമൊക്കെ പ്രശ്നം വന്ന എല്ലാവർക്കും ഭയങ്കര സന്തോഷമാണല്ലോ അപ്പൊ അത് കാണാനായിട്ട് നാട്ടുകാരൊക്കെ ഓടിക്കൂടിയിരുന്നു പരിഹസിക്കാൻ വേണ്ടി 10 ഓപ്പറേഷൻസ് തന്റെ ശരീരത്തിൽ ചെയ്തിട്ടും മുഖത്ത് ചെയ്തിട്ടാണ് നമുക്കുള്ളത് പോലെ ഒരു ഫേസ് എനിക്ക് ലഭിച്ചത് തന്റെ വളർച്ചയിൽ നമുക്ക് സംസാരിക്കുവാനായിട്ട് കർത്താവ് കൃപ ചെയ്ത് നമ്മൾ വളരെ സന്തോഷത്തോടെ ദൈവത്തെ ശ്രദ്ധിക്കുന്നുണ്ട് ഇതൊക്കെ അത് വോക്കൽ കോഡ് എന്ന് പറയുന്ന ഒരു ഓർഗനുണ്ട് അതാണ് നമുക്ക് ആ ശബ്ദത്തെ ഷേപ്പ് ചെയ്തത് പുറത്തു വിടുന്നത് എന്നാലും ഈ സുഹൃത്തിന് അവൻ ആ രണ്ടെണ്ണത്തിന് പോലെ ഒരെണ്ണമേ ഉള്ളൂ എന്റെ വാക്കുകൾ പറയുന്ന ഒന്നും ക്ലിയർ ആകത്തില്ലായിരുന്നു ഞാൻ സ്കൂളിൽ പോകുമ്പോൾ എല്ലാവരും തന്നെ കളിയാക്കും ഒരു നിന്നാപാത്രത്തെ പോലെ താൻ വളർന്നത് എൻ്റെ എല്ലാ ദിവസവും താൻ ക്ലാസ് വിട്ട് വീട്ടിൽ വന്നു കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ കരഞ്ഞോണ്ട വീട്ടിൽ വന്നിരിക്കുന്നത് അത്രമാത്രം എല്ലാവരും കളിയാക്കുന്നത് പക്ഷെ ആ സാഹചര്യത്തിൽ താൻ എഴുതിയ പാട്ടാണ് സൃഷ്ടാവാം ദൈവമേ അന്വേഷിച്ചു ഓ ഇന്ന് ക്രൈസ്തവ ലോകം മുഴുവൻ ഏറ്റുമാണെന്ന് അനുഗ്രഹിക്കപ്പെട്ട ഒരു ഗാനമാണ് ഞാൻ അവരോട് ചോദിച്ചു പോലെ ഈ പാടിക്കൊണ്ടിരുന്നപ്പോൾ എനിക്കിത് സഹിക്കാൻ കഴിയും ഞാൻ ദൈവസാര എനിക്ക് ഇരിക്കാൻ എനിക്ക് വളരെ ബുദ്ധിമുട്ട് തോന്നി ഞാൻ അവിടെ പാട്ട് നിർത്തിയിട്ട് പുറത്തു വന്നു ഞാൻ തന്നെ വിളിച്ചുകൊണ്ട് ചോദിച്ചു പോലെ നിനക്ക് എങ്ങനെ കഴിഞ്ഞു ഈ സൃഷ്ടാവിനെ ഇങ്ങനെ വർണ്ണിക്കാൻ കാരണം അതുപോലെ നല്ലൊരു സൃഷ്ടിയായിരുന്നില്ല നിന്റെ ജീവിതത്തിലുണ്ടായിരുന്നത് എന്നിട്ടും എങ്ങനെ സൃഷ്ടാവിനെ നിനക്ക് സ്തുതിക്കുവാൻ കഴിയുന്നു ആ ചിരിച്ചോടെ എന്നെ നോക്കിട്ട് വന്ന വെച്ചാൽ നമ്മുടെ കർത്താവായ യേശു ക്രിസ്തു കാൽവരിയും എൻ്റെ നിങ്ങളുടെയും പാപത്തിൻ്റെ പ്രായശ്ചിത്തമായി യാഗമായപ്പോൾ അവനെ കുറിച്ച് ഒരു വാക്യം ഇങ്ങനെ എഴുതി വെച്ചിട്ടുണ്ട് കണ്ടാൽ ആടല്ല എന്ന് തോന്നുമാറും തന്റെ മുഖം വിരൂപമാക്കണം തന്നോട് പറഞ്ഞു എനിക്കും നിങ്ങൾക്കും വേണ്ടി നമ്മുടെ കർത്താവ് അനുഭവിച്ച ആ വിരൂപതയെ ഓർക്കുമ്പോൾ ഇതൊന്നും ഒന്നുമല്ല ഈ ലോകത്ത് ഈ ജീവിതത്തിൽ നാം ആയിരിക്കുമ്പോൾ പ്രതികൂലങ്ങൾ കണ്ടേക്കാം ഒരുപാട് അനവധി പ്രതിസന്ധികൾ നമ്മുടെ മുമ്പിൽ കണ്ടേക്കാം വിശ്വസിക്കുക അതൊന്നും നിരന്തരമല്ല നമ്മെ സൃഷ്ടിച്ച നമ്മുടെ കർത്താവായ ദൈവം നമ്മെ കുറിച്ച് ഒരു പദ്ധതിയുണ്ട് അവൻ്റെ ഒരു വാഗ്ദത്തം നമ്മെ കുറിച്ച് പറഞ്ഞിട്ടുണ്ട് ആ സൃഷ്ടാവ് ഇതിനകത്തുണ്ട് അവൻ ജീവിക്കുന്ന ദൈവമാണ് ആ ദൈവത്തെ എത്ര പേർക്ക് വിശ്വാസത്തോടെ പറയാനും ദൈവം നമ്മെ ധാരാളമായ അനുഗ്രഹിക്കുക
Empire, I don't know. I want to be a body.
കർത്താവിന്റെ വഴികളിൽ തന്നെ നടക്കണം. എനിക്ക് എന്റെ യേശുവിന് ഇഷ്ടമാണ് എത്ര പേര് പറയും. എനിക്ക് അടുത്തിരിക്കുന്ന വ്യക്തിയെ കണ്ടിട്ടെന്ന് പറഞ്ഞു എനിക്ക് എന്റെ യേശുവിന്റെ ഭയങ്കര ഇഷ്ടമാണ്. നമുക്കൊന്ന് കർത്താവിനെ ഇന്ന് നാം ഒരുമിച്ച് കർത്താവിന്റെ സന്നിധിയിലായിരിക്കും. ഒരു അല്പസമയം കൂടെ ആ ദൈവത്തോടുള്ള സ്നേഹത്തെ ഒന്ന് വെളിപ്പെടുത്താൻ പോവുക. സന്തോഷമാണോ നമുക്ക്? ഹല്ലേലൂയ. ദൈവത്തെ ആരാധിക്കാൻ കൊതിയുള്ള എത്ര പേരുണ്ട് ഇതിനകത്ത്? എത്ര പേര് സന്തോഷത്തോടെ ദൈവത്തെ സ്തുതിക്കും? ഹല്ലേലൂയ പറയട്ടെ.
Love, love, love. നമ്മുടെ കർത്താവിനെ സ്തുതിക്കുന്നത് പോലെ പാട്ടി നമ്മുടെ ജീവിതത്തിൽ മറ്റൊന്ന് ഇല്ല. Amen. Tonight as we sit in the presence of God, I just want to bring some thoughts which God laid in my heart which will transform our life and I pray that God will come down and touch us as he has been here from the very beginning of this service in this evening time. Through the music, we experience the power of God. Now we are going to listen to the word of God and I want you to open up your heart. Lord, speak to me. As Pastor, respected man of God, Pastor Joe, open this session with his inaugural speech. It's such a joy to be together with him in this evening, too, though he has to leave earlier, but we are here together. And let's spend some time looking into God. God, speak to me. You know, God has a plan for every individual. Our life is not accidental. We are here for a purpose, and we shouldn't be leaving the world without completing that God-given purpose. Your past is a story. Your future is in your hand. But your present is what you need to make a decision so that your future, you can make a history. We are the people called by God to create a history in the kingdom of God. Doesn't matter who you were. Doesn't matter your background. Doesn't matter education. Doesn't matter who are your parents or what is the language you speak or education or economy of your life. But the matter to whom you are associating tonight is important. And calling tonight is abide with him. That is the key in our life. Abide with Jesus. Kuda partha. Yeshuvinodoppam vasikkuka. Hallelujah. Kathavinte invitation is to abide with him. I love the passage in Gospel of Mark chapter 3 verse 12, 13 following. When he was calling the disciple, he says, he called those whom he wanted. Tonight you are here because he wants you.
Amen.
Amen. Kathavinte namme avashyam. Kathavinu ningale chilad cheyvan. Kathav parayunnu that he called them, those whom he wanted, and appointed them as apostles and giving them the authority, and it says it, comma, so that they may be with him. Tannodu oppam irippaarum bhoodangalude melum sarvashaktikalude melum adhigaaram kodupaanum devam avare vilichu. Ee rathri as we are together, we are one to be with Jesus, because that is the greatest calling he is placing in our life. He wants to be with you and me. Kathavinte kathavinte nokki parayunnathu, he wants our company. Hallelujah. What an amazing privilege for you and me to have the company and the companionship of Jesus. He would like to walk with you, talk with you, move with you, and change your life for his glory and for his purpose. Tonight, let's turn to God. Turn your Bible with me for a short meditation to the Gospel of John chapter 4, verse 10, where Jesus is speaking to the Samaritan lady there. A powerful scripture which always has been speaking to my heart. Gospel of John, chapter 4, verse 10, it says, Jesus is speaking to the Samaritan lady. And he says three things there in that one scripture. He says, if you know the gift of God, number two, if you know whom you are talking to, number three, you would ask unto him and he would give you living waters. Amen. നീ ദൈവത്തിന്റെ ദാനവും നിന്നോട് സംസാരിക്കുന്നവൻ ആർ എന്നും നീ അറിഞ്ഞിരുന്നു എങ്കിൽ, that is the question. Something we ought to know, two things. There is something God planned for every individual. There is somebody who is bringing a gift of God. If we know these two things, either random number on the arranged, the third thing is we would ask him. Now Avanoda told him. And he says that he would give you living waters, not only for you. If you read verse number 13 and 14, which will turn into a spring within you. Hallelujah. എന്നെയും നിങ്ങളിൽ നിന്നും ജനത്തിങ്കലേക്ക് പടരുന്ന ഒരു ഉടമയായി മാറ്റുവാൻ നമ്മുടെ ജീവിതത്തെ കുറിച്ച് ദൈവത്തിന് ആവശ്യമുണ്ട്. There is nothing attractive or appreciated or approved by the society. No, absolutely nothing. He is considered to be the scum of the society, or an anathema to the family, or rejected by every individual. Life is torn into different pieces. She lived for the day, never thinking what God planned for her life, not knowing what is the and the purpose. She want to indulge everyday activities, thinking that is life. You know, that is the condition we see even in our Western world today. Eat, drink, and be merry. Tomorrow we will die, but they are forgetting they will die today. They are thinking tomorrow, no. They are dying today, and tomorrow will be their burial. They are dying every day. And this lady thought, in her life, running after the passions and the pleasures of the world could be bringing my life enjoyment and feature. But look at this lady. Asavadhyanokke, tanjirikkunnathu lokathinte purake poyi ishtangalil indulge athil jeevicha, that will satisfy my life. Ende jeevithathine shastrayam samthrupti undaagum. That's what people do today. Walking into the ways and the systems of the world, thinking that would bring benefit to their lives. But Jesus is telling, that is not what's going to happen. You need to know two things. Number one, Jesus says, forget who you were and who you are today. You need to know something God planned for you. There is a gift God prepared for you. ദൈവം നിനക്ക് വേണ്ടി ഹല്ലേലൂയ ഒരു ദാനം ഒരുക്കിയിട്ടുണ്ട്. എ ഗിഫ്റ്റ് ഹി പ്രിപ്പയർഡ്. ഇറ്റ്സ് നോട്ട് ബിക്കോസ് ഓഫ് ഹു യു ആർ. ഇറ്റ്സ് നോട്ട് സംതിങ് വി ആർ മെറിറ്റഡ് ഓർ ക്രെഡിറ്റഡ് വിത്ത് അവർ ഓൺ എഫേർട്ട്. ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് പ്യുവർലി എ ഗിഫ്റ്റ് ഗോഡ് പ്ലാൻഡ്. ഹല്ലേലൂയ. ഈ രാത്രി ഇറ്റ്സ് നോട്ട് എ മാറ്റർ നമ്മുടെ ജീവിതം എന്തുമാത്രം താഴ്ക്കപ്പെട്ടതോ. ഇറ്റ്സ് നോട്ട് എ മാറ്റർ ഹൗ ഡീപ്പ് ആർ യുവർ പ്രോബ്ലം. It's a matter you need to know two things in your life. Look at this lady. She's coming to the well. What is the timing? It's a noon time. Usually, if you look at the book of Genesis chapter 24 or 18, you could see people never come during the noon time, especially in the Middle Eastern culture or even in our Indian culture. Then people want to draw the water. They may go either in the morning or in the evening. People will never go during the lunchtime because that is number one, hot sun up there. Number two, that is the time people sit together, eat together as a family. The lunch is a big meal in the Eastern culture, so they love to be at a family. But look at this lady, she is coming to draw the water because nobody is willing to give her a company. She is all alone in the crowd. In the village, her life is a launder. She is all alone. ആർക്കും തന്നോടൊപ്പം നടക്കുവാൻ ഇഷ്ടമില്ല. താൻ മറ്റു കുട്ടികളോടൊപ്പം നടന്നാൽ പോലും എന്നോടൊപ്പം നടക്കരുത്. കാരണം നിന്നെ എന്നോടൊപ്പം നടന്നാൽ ഞാൻ നിന്നെ പോലെ ചിന്തിക്കും. സോ ഐ ഡോണ്ട് വാണ്ട് യു ബിക്കോസ് യുവർ ലൈഫ് ഈസ് റൂയിൻഡ്. യു ഹാവ് നോ ടെസ്റ്റിമണി. യു ആർ നോട്ട് അപ്രീഷിയേറ്റഡ് ബൈ മൈ പീപ്പിൾ. സോ വി ഡോണ്ട് വാണ്ട് യു ടു കം. ഷി വുഡ് ഹാവ് ട്രൈഡ്. പീപ്പിൾ വുഡ് ഹാവ് പുഷ്ഡ് ഹർ ബാക്ക്. ദാറ്റ്സ് വാട്ട് ഐ ആം തിങ്കിംഗ്. ലൈഫ് വിതൗട്ട് മീനിംഗ്. A broken vessel. And she is a Samaritan lady thinking she could win the heaven and the earth with the thing she is doing. But for Jesus, she is precious. For Jesus, she is a child. For Jesus, she is created in His image. For Jesus, she needs to experience the transformation power of God. Beloved, tonight your problem is not a big problem. The crisis you're going through, or the accusation or the abuse you face is not a big deal. But tonight, God wants to tell you something which will turn your life upside down because you are already upside down. What Jesus needs to do is, you are walking upside down, thinking you are straight, and He wants to make you one more upside down so that you will walk straight. Tonight, His calling and His invitation for all of us as a believer's community and all of us who are here needs to know the love and the power of God. Jesus says, something you ought to know, something you ought to ask. Jesus is saying, there is some gift God planned for you. You know, salvation is available irrespective of who we are. Culture, color, language, country, ethnicity is not a matter in the kingdom of God. Invitation is open for any culture, color, and creed. It is found only in the name of Jesus under the heavens. Above here, there is no other name but the name of Jesus. Every knee shall bow down, every tongue shall confess, whether you and I agree or disagree. My God is in the business of turning people to His kingdom. Tonight, the calling is for you and me. Look at this thing. Jesus is telling you, you need to know the gift of God. You need to know that. You have to understand there is a gift available for you. When Jesus is speaking, I want you to turn your Bible and travel with me to when Paul is speaking to the people in Romans in chapter 6 verse 23. That is where Paul is speaking. For the wages of sin is death. Look at this lady. If you could and I could call her, we would name her with a different name. A lady married many men. Or a lady having a loose life. Or a lady who can be termed as a prostitute. You name it. Whatever title you could put it, she is okay for it. She can fit it there. But Jesus says, the sin you have committed, there is a wage waiting. The wages of your sin is death. The Old Testament law says you need to be thrown to death. As per the Old Testament custom, she is no more eligible to live. Thank God she is in Samaria. If she were in Israel, she would have been thrown to death. Since she is Samaria, she is still living. Jesus is saying, your wages is already placed there. You are condemned to be killed. But Paul, in his divine vision, he says, but the gift of God is eternal life. The systems of the world wants to kill you. The systems of the world is willing to throw a stone at you. The systems of the world want to see you cursed to life. But God says, no, no, something new I have planned. You need to know the gift of God is eternal life. Amen. The invitation in our life is to know there is a gift of God. We are not called to live under the systems of the world. We are created to live under the system of heaven. We are called to operate by the power of heavenly king and its principles. We are not created to operate in the earthly ways. That's what we are created. I always ask the people, imagine your capacity to fight with any creatures of the world. Can you fight with a dog? And can you win over? Can you fight with a big cat? Can you win over? No. We have no claws to fight. If we have no better teeth to bite. You are not created to fight physically. You are created with a power from above, which is moving within you. God's power needs to move through your words. In the Garden of Eden, Adam is calling everything by the name. It's not showing its power. You come here, he spoke and they came. That is the power God has given. But people in their worldly life, in their sinful nature, they lost it. And Jesus is saying, now you are living for the world. Your calling is to receive the eternal life. Live in the heavenly perspective. Stop your life of earthly indulgence. ഭൂമിയിലെ നന്മകൾ നീ നന്മയെന്ന് ചിന്തിച്ച് അതിന്റെ പുറകെ നിന്റെ ഇഷ്ടപ്രകാരം ജീവിക്കുന്ന ജീവിതത്തെ മാറ്റിയിട്ട് സിദ്ധാവാൻ ദൈവം എന്നെയും നിങ്ങളെയും തന്റെ പദ്ധതി പ്രകാരം സ്വർഗീയമായ നിക്ഷേപത്തിന് വേണ്ടി സിദ്ധിച്ചു എന്നറിഞ്ഞ് ആ ദാനം ഈ രാത്രി സ്വീകരിക്കണം എന്നതാണ് ദൈവത്തിന്റെ ഇൻവിറ്റേഷൻ. People do not know why Pastor Finney and the family and the church made this possible. They have a passion on this Christmas season. People ought to hear the name Jesus. They need to know Christ. We have wonderful singers here. They need to know the power of God when they come here, sing and praise God. Tonight there is an invitation to know the gift of God. Beloved, we are called to know the gift of God. You know, once you know the gift which is waiting for you, you will not live for the world. You will live for that kingdom to receive that gift. The gift is already given, but not until it's performed. The deposit is already made. Our engagement of receiving that gift is already over. Who accepted this invitation, who knew there is a gift waiting for me, but there are people who are yet to know there is an invitation waiting to receive this eternal life. Jesus is saying, people, stop living in the worldly way. Come to me. I want to give you the gift of eternal life. Beloved people of God, even as a believers and the children of God, I want you to focus your attention to the heavenly calling where the gift of eternal life is waiting. We are not called to live and indulge in the worldly things, but we are called to look unto God and move on. Tonight, may we align our life to God and say, God, I know the gift is waiting for me, and I want to receive that gift. Jesus is telling this to this lady. Yes, the gift of God is eternal life, which you do not know. She thought, no, I can live and die one day. I don't know. I don't care where I go. But Jesus says, that is the end of your life. You will go and die and enter into eternal hell. But I want to turn your life to heaven. I want to offer this gift of eternal life. Look at Jesus. Jesus could have walked like the other Jews. But Jesus has taken a turn, a deviation than the other people, coming to the well of where this lady is. He is passionate for this lady because he knew this woman is going to come here. This woman is going to be here in the noontime to draw the water. Jesus took all the pain for this single lady. But let me tell you, Jesus is willing to take any pain for your salvation, for your healing, for your redemption. Only thing, can you acknowledge him and say, yes, Lord, I understand there is a gift waiting for me. Hallelujah. People need to know this gift. Tonight, there are people here who already experienced there is a gift for me. I want you to reorganize your life. Are we focusing on that gift and living? And if there are anybody here tonight who never experienced the gift of God, if you are living for today, the calling on you is acknowledging this gift. You receive this gift tonight. Your life will never, ever be the same. Your life will be totally transformed. Number two, Jesus is telling to this lady, you need to know who you are talking to or who he is speaking to. She heard about Messiah. She read about Messiah, but she never knew or understand one who is speaking to her is the Messiah. Once you know the gift, you need to know who is the giver of that gift. The calling of a Christian is to know Jesus Christ and his power. Many people, many believers know about Christ, but our calling is to not to know about Christ, but to know Christ. Have a close communion with Jesus. നമ്മുടെ കർത്താവിനെ കുറിച്ചറിയുവാനല്ല. Wherever you go, He is your best companion. He doesn't want to leave you because He wants to abide with you. And He is calling, can you abide with me? As the branch cannot abide with the vine, it will never be able to produce any fruit. Forget about fruit. It cannot live by itself. The calling tonight is to grow deeper and deeper and deeper into the fellowship of Christ. We need to know Christ. I love the scripture. If you turn your Bible to Ephesians chapter 1 verse 17, a powerful scripture in Malayalam. There is a big confusion. I appreciate if you could read it in English in NIV. It says, I pray and plead unto God so that He may open your eyes, so that He may fill you with the spirit of wisdom and revelation. You need two things. You need to have a spirit of wisdom and revelation. Amen. Wisdom is the practical application of knowledge. When you know there is a gift waiting, then you need to have a wisdom to practically apply that knowledge in your daily life. And number two, you need to have a revelation. Revelation is something mystery which God reveals to His people. That means these two things are operating when you get the Spirit of God. Then He said, so that you may know Him better. Hallelujah. I like that English word there. You may know Him better. Praise the Lord. There is a good, there is a best. But better is a relative term. A comparative degree in English classification. This is a good mic. I can have a better mic. This is a good watch. I can have a better watch. This is something good. Cord. I can have a better cord. Better always aim higher and higher and higher. That means Christians calling by Jesus is to know Christ every day better, better, and better. Our life is not stagnant knowing Christ. That's it. No, you cannot understand and fathom the fullness of Christ. It is a growing knowledge. It's a growing knowledge. How this knowledge will be increasing. My beloved wife and child are sitting there. We have been married for last, should I say, 20 years now. Okay? Even today we are knowing. Last month, two months I was away. She said, I never thought you would decide to go away for 2 months. Now I am knowing you. You could even do that. Without my consultation, you took a leave of 2 months. I never thought you would do it. She is knowing my new character. How does she know? Through associating with me. She never knew this one last year. She never knew this character 2 months ago. Because we are connected together, now she knows this man could run away for 2 months. That's a new knowledge. Jesus' knowledge is something cognitive. You need to know through your knowledge, associating with Him. It's not when you read a book about Jesus or a book about Christology you will get it. It is a knowledge of associating with Him. Tonight, beloved, our calling as a Christians and believers is to walk with Him, know His deeper love for you, His compassion for you, His provision for you. Your knowledge will be better and better and better. When it is best of the knowledge, you will be with Him up there. He says, come on boy, I want you to be with me. Now you know of me everything. That's what Enoch walked with God, and he knew fully about God, and he said, I don't want you to live there anymore because you know me fully. Now you come to me. Amen. Our knowledge of Christ will be completed when we are taken up there with Him. Till then, it's the knowledge ever increasing, better and better and better. Hallelujah. Jesus says, you need to know whom you are talking. Can we say to Jesus, Jesus, I want to know you more. I want to know you more. I want to have a very close affinity with you. Oh God, in book of Philippians chapter 3 verse 10, Paul says, oh, I may know Christ. Hallelujah. I love that he says, I may know Christ. I want to experience. I want to enjoy. I want to walk with the suffering of Christ. as Pastor Lawson said, it said here, suffering, when he was singing that song which Roman wrote, is not something you will be worrying, rather something you will enjoy. That is Christian life. Suffering, you will look at, smile it and say, come on, I can have it, because that is nothing compared to the suffering I see in Jesus Christ. He suffered for me. He died for me. As we sing this beautiful, beautiful song, I have decided to follow Jesus. You know the story of an Assami man who is from a particular tribe, came to Christ in Christian faith, and he was killed. In front of him, the first son killed, and the second one killed, and the village head is saying, come on, you turn back to our religion. He says, no, 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 I cannot turn back. And the village head is telling, I'm going to kill your wife. You need to turn. He says, you take the whole world, but give me Jesus, not turning back. His wife was killed. And the arrow is pointing under him and says, we are going to kill you. You could renounce Jesus and come back and live among us as one among them. He said, no, the cross before me, the world is behind me, not turning back. You know, when he was shot dead, when he was dying there, the village had looked unto him and said, there is something on this family. There is something on these people. Even the death of their beloved one, blood and flesh cannot separate them from their God. Even the killing of their own spouse cannot separate. Even their own life cannot separate from Christ. There is something deeper here than any of our faith. I want to be a Christian on this burial ground. And he turned it out. And the whole village, whole community today are Christian because that couple took and they took the pain. Beloved, tonight, when you suffer, when you go through the problem, let us not grumble or mumble and say, I am participating with the suffering of Christ, that one day I will know the power of resurrection. Only the master wonder, we wear the medal cup for my, we have been the Shakti, yet they say that today we have been the Kumna, only the master wonder, and then the wear the medal. Jesus is calling you and me. Doesn't matter who you are, what is your problem or your past history. He says, come to me. I want to turn your life around and make you a prosperous blessing unto you and to the society. People are going to listen to you. How many of you believe Jesus is willing to turn my life around? My life is going to be the blessed one around the world. As my beloved pastors were sharing the story here, when they started to sing and play, they never thought they would be singing in England. But they said, God who promised is faithful. Amen. Beloved, when you and I become a follower of Jesus, the sky is the limit. Amen. Nobody, no powers of earth can limit you. Because you are knowing who is Christ. This knowledge will take you one level every day. One day at a time, sweet Jesus. One day at a time. Teach me today. Show me the way. One day at a time. That is the calling. When you look at the book of Ephesians chapter 2, verse 8 and 9, Paul is continually saying, for by grace you have been saved. You and I receive this gift of God. Because the giver, you know, it is not something you can work or earn so that no one can boast. There is nothing I can achieve even through my work. You know, there is a tragic teaching in the world. Even in the churches, you do. I say you do, you will die. You trust in Christ, trust, you will live. You cannot do and go to heaven because it's already done. He's not calling you to do so that you can earn it. That is the world system. If I work 8 hours, they will pay me 8 hours money. But grace under heaven is not something I can do and give me. No, God is not calling beggars. He's giving gift. People who are willing to receive. This is the gift. Beggar work and say, hey, this is something I am owning. You give it to me. I can demand basis. No. This is a gift. Whoever is willing, come. Receive it. I am the giver. You ought to know. For by grace you have been saved through faith. So that it is not something you can earn, so that no one can boast. Tonight the mediator of salvation is Jesus Christ. There is no mediator, as we read in the book of 1 Timothy chapter 2 verse 5. It says, for there is only one God, and there is only one mediator between God and man, the man Christ Jesus. Tonight, let me tell you, beloved, there is only one mediator. I have no big guru, good teachers of the world. I have no good saints who can take me to heaven. I have only one God who came as a man and died for me on the cross and said, I am giving you the gift and the invitation. Come and know me. I am willing to give you this gift. As you read in the book of Hebrews, chapter 8, verse 6, it says, this is the superior mediator of a superior covenant of, I see, if I put it, it says, a superior promise. I like those three things. Or, if we read it in NIV, it is a covenant of better promise. There are good promises, but this is something better. Today, the invitation is to receive this better promise for your life, which can take you to eternity. Would you please turn to God and say, yes, Lord, I need this gift tonight. And if you read in the book of Hebrews, chapter 9, verse 15, again it says, he is a superior mediator of the new covenant. And chapter 12, verse 24, is again confirming there is one mediator of the new covenant, that is Christ Jesus. Jesus is the only bridge between heaven and the earth, and through which anybody can reach the heaven. And he says, you ought to know this Christ. He's saying, Jesus is saying, come unto me. I want to take you to heaven. Don't worry about your life. Don't worry about what happened. And Jesus is telling, if you know these two things, the gift and the giver, third thing is available to anybody. You ask unto him. He will give you living waters. You came to draw the water. You drink and die. I'm going to give you water. You drink and live forever. It will take you to eternity. So far, you were drinking, nothing is coming out. Jesus says, this water will not only satisfy your life, it will satisfy many others' life. You know, the blessings of God is very contagious. I like it. When God gifted them with the singing, it's very contagious. When they sing, we do sing. Whether you follow the rhythm or not, we always sing. When he dances, we automatically, we try to hold, but the leg is moving because it is contagious. The blessings of God is contagious. When you see Pastor Bijoy and his beautiful wife sing, it is contagious. And the church here is fighting and doing it. It is contagious. Blessings of God is contagious. It should spread and spread and spread. And God is saying, Samaritan lady, your life was ruined in the past, but tonight I am going to turn it around to be a blessing. Only if you want to say, God, I know the gift, I know the giver. Now I need to know the third element. I want the living water to flow in me and through me. You know, we always want me. I want you to evaluate your prayer every day morning. God bless me, me. Me and myself. Bless me. Open the heavens for me. Open the doors for me. Everything is open. We are still saying, open. I am used to, what is the door which is closed? Nothing is closed. Still you are praying, open and open. We, Jesus says, you walk, it will be open. The door looks closed. You believe and walk, it will be open. You are still begging, open and open. He says, you go and take it. That is the promise. Jesus calling for us not only to be blessed, but become a blessing. That is the calling for this lady's life. Jesus is saying, if you know this gift, you would ask after him. He will give you living waters. Tonight, believers, my fellow people, whoever Are you listening to me? Jesus is calling you to be a blessing. So far, if you've never been a blessing, Jesus says, I want to make you a blessing. People who said you are a curse, how many of you want to see? They are going to tell you are a blessing. You have blessed me. People said your life is useless. They are going to come and say, hey, you blessed my life. Look at this lady. She came alone to the valley to draw the water. You read chapter 4, verse 27. I like that verse. It says, she left the pot. What did she do? She left the pot. And she ran to the village. Earlier, she is intimidated. She has no courage. When she met Jesus Christ and she knew who Christ is and she understood there is a giver and the gift is there, her whole life is changed. And she is now running back to the village and telling me everybody, hey, come with me, come on. I met a man who spoke about all my Lord. He perhaps would be the Messiah. I want you to come and see with me. Now look at this lady who came alone to draw the water. Her life priority was changed. She came to satisfy the physical need of her family. Now when she met Jesus Christ, she understood this pot is absolutely nothing, have no value. I have been drawing from this well every day till it is thirsty. I am going to throw the pot away. I am going to run to the village and say to everybody, I met Messiah. You come and see me. I want you to visualize with me. Look at this lady. She came alone to the valley. She went to the village. Now come on. She was an unwanted lady. Now she is the leader in the kingdom. She's walking as a giant because the whole village is behind her. Taking the whole village to Jesus and saying, this is Messiah. This is Messiah. Nobody listened to her, not even a single lady was willing to come with her to the well to draw the water. When she met Jesus, the situation changed. Let me tell you, when you meet Jesus, your situation will change. People are not looking down on you, they are looking upon you because you carry Christ, who is the Savior of the world. It's not a matter who you were in the past. Tonight he wants to change your life and say, I am Messiah. And the whole village wants to hear Jesus. Do you want to be a blessing tonight? Do you want to see people coming to Christ through you? Throw the pot away. Go to the people. Tell them, I met a guy who ruined all of my life. He is Messiah. Come and see him. Tonight, the challenge is upon you and me. I am going to close it here with a word of prayer. But before that, let me assure you, if there are anybody here having a life of sorrow and pain, your problems have not been solved, you think who can find a solution for me? Jesus says, come unto me. Those who are thirsty and weary, I'm going to give you rest. There the rest is the word shalom, the tranquility and the wholeness. Nothing lacking, nothing want. Everything is there. But it is based on your decision. Jesus says, you need to know the gift. You need to know the giver. But rest is upon you. You need to ask. Tonight, that ball is on your court. You need to ask him, Jesus, this is what I need. If you came here tonight with a sickness, with a problem on your body, or a problem in your family, problem on your job, let me assure you, Jesus is willing to change your life. Jesus is willing to transform your life. Your sickness, Jesus is willing to heal you. Your problems of your life, Jesus is willing to heal you. But only if you ask him. I cannot ask for you. I am not the mediator. Jesus is the mediator. I cannot stand in the gap and say, God, do this. You need to speak. When you speak, we the servants of God will pray for you. But it is your decision. Tonight, shall we all stand up together in the presence of God? How many of you really want to say, God, my life is broken. My life is ruined. Nobody listened to me. But I have been a believer. but I want to be like this Samaritan lady. Look at this lady, she's coming to the kingdom of God with a whole village. How many of you want to say, I want to be like that lady? Jesus, I want to change in my life. If that is you, I want you to pray to Jesus. Would you please close your eyes with me? Hallelujah. Jesus wants to change you. You thought your life is ruined. You thought your life is an end. Jesus says, I'm going to do something different for you. If you walked in here with a burdened heart, with a broken spirit, God says, I want to heal you. If you need a touch of God in your life, put your hand on your chest and say to God, Jesus, as that Samaritan healing, I come to you. As Samaritan spirit upon me, Taharna Jividomai, Yantiri Sadhguru. ഞാനായിരിക്കുന്നത് പോലെ തിരുസന്നിധി വരുന്നു. അത് എന്നോട് തുടങ്ങി. ഐ ആം നോ മോർ ദ സ്കം ഓഫ് ദ സൊസൈറ്റി. ഞാൻ സമൂഹത്തിന്റെ ശാപമല്ല, ഞാൻ കുടുംബത്തിന്റെ ശാപമല്ല, ഞാൻ എന്റെ സമൂഹത്തിനും എന്റെ കുടുംബത്തിനും അനുഗ്രഹമാണ്. എന്നെ ശപിച്ചവരുടെ മധ്യത്തിൽ ഞാൻ അനുഗ്രഹിക്കപ്പെട്ടവനായി പെട്ടവളായി ദൈവം എന്നെ നിർത്താൻ പോവുകയാണ്. ഈ രാത്രി എന്നെ ഭാരപ്പെടുന്ന വിഷയമായി ഞാൻ തിരുസന്നിധി വരുന്നു. എന്നെ സ്വീകരിക്കണമേ കർത്താവേ. ഇതിനകത്ത് ആരെങ്കിലും ഇതുവരെ ഈ നന്മ, ഈ ദാനം, ഈ ഗിഫ്റ്റ് സ്വീകരിച്ചിട്ടില്ല എങ്കിൽ ജീസസ് ഈസ് കോളിംഗ് യു ടുനൈറ്റ്. ദിസ് ഗിഫ്റ്റ് ഈസ് ഓപ്പൺ ടു യു. ഈസ് ദേർ എനിബഡി വാണ്ട് ടു സേ യെസ് ലോർഡ്, ഐ ആം വില്ലിംഗ് ടു റിസീവ് ദിസ് ഗിഫ്റ്റ്. ഐ വാണ്ട് ടു നോ യു, ഐ വാണ്ട് ടു നോ യുവർ പവർ. ആസ് എവരിബഡി പ്രേ, വുഡ് യു പ്ലീസ് ലിഫ്റ്റ് അപ്പ് യുവർ ഹാൻഡ്സ് ടു ഹെവൻ. Saying to God, I heard this message. As Jesus transformed the Samaritan lady, I want to experience a transformation in my life. As Jesus changed her from a scum of the society to be a successful leader in the kingdom, I want to be a blessing to my people. Shabikapatavala yana peregunna anigrihikapatavalai anna shamariyakariyamachi thapole ee rakri ennei.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Please be seated. thank you so much for listening to me. Let me promise you, Jesus is your companion, but he wants to walk with you. Amen. It's not too late to acknowledge him. It's not too late to become a leader in the kingdom of God. Let's have that close companion with Jesus in this season of our life so that world may know Jesus. Amen. Thank you, Pastor, for this time.
Sabe?
കർത്താവേ ഇവിടെ വിലപ്പെട്ട ബുദ്ധിമാരെ ഇന്ന് രാത്രി അങ്ങ് ഉപയോഗിച്ചല്ലോ കർത്താവെ. കർത്താവിൻ്റെ ദാസൻ പാസ്റ്റർ റോഷൻ ആന്റണിയെ ഇന്ന് രാത്രി അങ്ങയുടെ നാമത്തെ ഉയർത്തുവാൻ ഗാനശുശ്രൂഷയിലൂടെ അമ്മയെ ഞങ്ങൾ സഹായിച്ചതിന് കാര്യം നന്ദി ഹൃദയത്തോടെ സ്തുതിക്കുന്നു. അടുത്ത നാളുകളിൽ അങ്ങേ ഏക്കുന്ന ഇടങ്ങളിൽ അങ്ങേ അമ്മയെ ഉയർത്തുവാൻ അങ്ങേ ആത്മാക്കളെ നേടുവാൻ ഞങ്ങളുടെ ദാസിൻ്റെ ശുശ്രൂഷയെങ്ങ് മാനിക്കണമേ. ഞങ്ങളുടെ ദാസൻ പാസ്റ്റർ ജ്ഞാനദാസിനെ കർത്താവേ ഹാലും ഇന്ന് രാത്രി ഇവിടേക്ക് അയച്ചതിനായി സ്തോത്രം. ഞങ്ങളുടെ വചനം എത്ര മാധുര്യമുള്ളത്, ഹല്ലേലൂയ. പലപ്പോഴും ഞങ്ങൾ ആരെന്ന് മനസ്സിലാക്കുവാതെ അങ്ങയോട് അടുത്തു വരുന്ന ഞങ്ങളുടെ ആ മനോഭാവത്തെ ഇന്ന് രാത്രി ഞങ്ങൾ തിരുത്തുന്നു. കർത്താവേ ഞങ്ങൾ അങ്ങയുടെ ദാനമാണല്ലോ, ഹല്ലേലൂയ. ഇന്ന് രാത്രി ആരെങ്കിലും നിരാശയോടെ ഭാരത്തോടെ വേദനയോടെ കൂടി ആയിരിക്കുന്നെങ്കിൽ കർത്താവേ ഞങ്ങൾ അങ്ങയുടെ ദാനമാണെന്നുള്ളൊരു തിരിച്ചറിവ്, അങ്ങ് ഞങ്ങളെ ഏത് ഉദ്ദേശത്തിന് വേണ്ടി മെനഞ്ഞുവെന്ന് കർത്താവേ ഞങ്ങളെ പറ്റി അങ്ങയുടെ പദ്ധതി എന്താണെന്ന് തിരിച്ചറിയുവാൻ കർത്താവേ അങ്ങ് ഞങ്ങളെ സഹായിച്ചതിനായി സ്തോത്രം. അപ്പോൾ തന്നെ ഈ നശിച്ചു പോകുന്ന ലോകത്തിൽ നിലനിൽക്കാത്ത ദാനങ്ങളുടെ പുറകെ പോകാതെ നിത്യജീവനെ മുഖം പിടിക്കുവാൻ, നിത്യ ദാനത്തിന് വേണ്ടി ഞങ്ങളുടെ ജീവിതത്തെ ഒരു ഭാഷ്യം കൂടെ സമർപ്പിക്കാൻ ഇന്ന് രാത്രി ഈ മീറ്റിംഗിന് കാരണമായതിനായി സ്തോത്രം. വാത്സല്യ സഭയെ ഇവിടെ ശുശ്രൂഷിക്കുന്ന ഞങ്ങളുടെ ദാസിനെ ഞങ്ങളുടെ കരുത്തിൽ കീഴ്പ്പിക്കുന്നു. അങ്ങയുടെ വരവിന് താമസമെങ്കിലെ അനേക ആത്മാക്കളെ ഈ സഭയിലേക്ക് ഈ ദേശത്തിലേക്ക് അങ്ങ് അയക്കണമേ കർത്താവേ. ഞങ്ങൾ വിശ്വസിക്കുന്നു അങ്ങ് ഈ ദേശത്തെ ഉണർത്താൻ പോകുന്ന നാളുകളാണ്. ഹല്ലേലൂയ. ഞങ്ങൾ ഒന്നിച്ചിന്ന് രാത്രി ഈ ദേശത്തിൻ്റെ വിടുതലിന് വേണ്ടി ഈ സഭയുടെ ഉണർവിന് വേണ്ടി പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു. കർത്താവ് പ്രകാരം ചെയ്യാൻ പോകുന്നതിനായി സ്തോത്രം. മുഴുവൻ മഹത്വം അങ്ങേക്ക് അർപ്പിക്കുന്നു. ഞങ്ങളുടെ നാമത്തിൽ താനുടെ ഹൃദയത്തോടെ വീക്ഷിക്കുന്നു. ഹൃദയത്തോടെ നമുക്ക് അമേൻ ഹല്ലേലൂയ കരയറ്റാം. ഹല്ലേലൂയ ഹല്ലേലൂയ ഹല്ലേലൂയ. കർത്താവേ അനുഗ്രഹിക്കുമാറാകട്ടെ.